Welcome to the service clinic at Low Country Harley-Davidson. I'm Doc Harley. Had a young man come in and purchase a 2010 Road King. He was very proud of it. His dad was happy too. And he was talking to me about maintenance. And he said, what about the primary chain? When should I adjust it? And I said, well, you have a 2010 Road King. Harley-Davidson has an automatic primary adjusting unit inside your motorcycle. And he said, but my dad had an Evolution and he was constantly adjusting and making sure that was perfect. What does a primary adjuster do? I said, all right, I'll make a video about it. So let's start with an early model. Up until 1965, Harley-Davidson had the process of, well, you have the motor, the primary, and the transmission. Up until 1965, you had to loosen the transmission and move the transmission to get the correct primary chain adjustment. In 1965, Harley-Davidson decided, let's make an adjustable one that you can do inside here. All right, so it's manual, but it makes it a whole lot easier than moving the transmission and then adjusting the rear chain also. So how this works is you loosen the 9/16 nut and you raise and lower this until you get the right specification. Now, in the manual, it does say it works out better if you take your spark plugs out, put it in the highest gear, and rotate your motor till you find the tight spot, and then do the adjustment there by raising and lowering. Now, in your manual, it'll give a specification on how much deflection you should have. Use a ruler and measure. From the bottom, move it up until it's done. All right, and that's the adjustment. How this works is this is set up with teeth on both sides. And as you lift up, it engages the teeth and then you tighten down the nut. This is a later model style versus the shovel head here that had the bolt going all the way through. And you have this nylon shoe that you should probably inspect 50,000, 100,000 miles. I mean, you've got oil in here lubricating, so it doesn't destroy itself on a short basis. They last pretty long. Then in 2006, Harley-Davidson changed the adjuster. In 2006, Harley-Davidson designed the automatic primary chain adjuster. Let me take this one out and show you the different parts. Still has the shoe, made out of better material. Still has the teeth, just like the earlier model. Has teeth here and teeth here. Has this spring, and a lot of people don't know, it also has two inner springs that also give in between the notches, and so it keeps the primary chain at the correct response, or the measurement it should be, until it's time for this to ratchet to the next side. So, in putting this back together again, there's a little trick I learned. If you have an old-fashioned little screwdriver with the square edges, put it inside. And rotate it. Slide it out. Now you'll probably have to use a tie wrap to tie it. This little unit comes with brand new ones. And it goes back in with the two bolts. Now, Harley-Davidson in 2007 decided that they found some improvements that could be made with this unit. Let me show you the difference between the very first one and the B unit that we are running now. The very first unit had a very thin base and had very aggressive teeth. The newer models, which this one is, a B model, has a very thick bottom and has very fine teeth. This helped in metering the measurement in the adjustment of this automatic primary chain adjuster. Now there is an Achilles heel to this unit. And that is making a lot more horsepower than the factory designed for the motor and having a very aggressive throttle hand. Let me show you why. When you've got a lot of horsepower and you give it the gas, this top chain tightens up because this is rotating and pulling as hard as it can. With this tight, this bottom one gets loose. When it gets loose, then it ratchets up to the next spot. Now you get off the gas. This comes down loose, this gets tight. Now you get back on it, this gets back tight, you've got a little more space, this ratchets up. The more you do this, and the more horsepower that you've made, this gets tighter and tighter until it's way too tight. All right. For a stock Harley-Davidson, I have many customers with over 100,000 miles on their motorcycle where they still have the stock primary adjuster, their bearings are fine, the adjustment is fine too. If you're curious, if your weekend little shenanigans had a lot of fun over the weekend and want to know, did mine ratchet up too much? You can check it. Have your bike held upright, take your turbo cover off, take a long screwdriver and a flashlight, slide the screwdriver in, and move the primary chain. If you can move it, you have all right adjustment. If it's bone tight, you might want to think about taking your primary cover off, draining the oil, taking the primary cover, and readjusting this down to the minimum so it can ratchet back up to where it should be working. If you own a 1985 to 2006, well, 2005 model, and you would like to get away from manual adjustment, Harley-Davidson does offer a retro kit to put this on your earlier model. The part number is 40063-05B, and you can follow the instructions, and this would install into your earlier model, and you won't have to adjust your primary that much. Hope this answered your question about primaries. Hope you ride safe on your 2010 Road King. And I'm Doc Harley. We'll see you next week.